In this video, you'll learn how to set up I/O mapping in the RCS module and simulate internal signal control for a robot using the monitoring window or a block for sending signals. We're working with a KUKA KR10R1100-2 robot, a gripper, and four colored boxes, blue, yellow, red, and green. Let's start with clicking on the robot and moving to the Program tab. In the config.dat file, we've declared a global signal called ColorNumb. This signal carries a 16-bit integer value and is mapped to input channels 120 through 135. This integer value is used in a switch case statement to determine which output should be activated and which box should be picked. Here's how it works. If ColorNumb equals 10, output 103 is activated and the robot picks the blue box. If ColorNumb equals 20, output 104 is activated and the robot picks the yellow box. If ColorNumb equals 30, output 105 is activated and the robot picks the red box. If ColorNumb has any other value, the default case is triggered, output 106 is activated, and the robot picks the green box. At the beginning of the program, there's a loop that waits for a rising edge on input 19. Once that signal is received, the robot checks the value of ColorNumb and jumps to the corresponding case. To monitor and simulate the signal behavior, open the monitoring window in iiQWorks.Sim and enter the following inputs. $in119, which will be our trigger input. The inputs $in120 through $in124 are the bits used for encoding the integer signal. You can also list the outputs that are controlled by the switch case logic. $out103, $out104, $out105, $out106. Important: this method of writing to robot inputs only works in the robot controller simulation RCS module. It does not work in virtual robot controller VRC or on a physical robot controller RC. So make sure you're using the RCS module when testing this logic. Now let's start the simulation. As you can see, all robot inputs are currently set to false. That means the ColorNumb signal is holding the value 0. You can verify this by checking the signal in the monitoring window. Since the value is 0, the logic enters the default case. Output 106 is activated, and the robot picks the green box. The system now waits for a positive edge on input 119 before re-evaluating the logic. Let's change the ColorNumb value to 10. To do this, we need to set the correct bits in inputs 120 to 124. Once the value is set, toggle input 119 from false to true to trigger the logic. Now the robot picks the blue box, and output 103 is activated. Next, let's simulate picking the yellow box. We set ColorNumb to 20 by adjusting the bit values accordingly. Again, toggle input 119 to create a positive edge. The robot now picks the yellow box, and output 104 is activated. Finally, let's simulate the red box. Set ColorNumb to 30 by combining the correct bit values. Toggle input 119 once more. The robot picks the red box, and output 105 is activated. This confirms that the switch case logic works correctly for all defined values. You can now use this setup to validate your I/O mapping and signal handling with the RCS module. If you don't want to work with the monitoring window, there's a faster way to manually wire the robot inputs using the modeling add-on. The following procedure will also work with the VRC. Start by selecting any model in your layout. For example, you can use a simple block. Go to the Modeling tab and use the Modeling add-on to add Boolean signals. Add 6 Boolean signals to represent the robot inputs we've been using. Input 119, which will be our trigger input. The input 120 to 124 are the bits used for encoding the integer signal ColorNumb. Once added, go to the Signals tab. You'll see the inputs and outputs listed there. Now assign each signal to the corresponding robot input. In 119, in 120, in 121, in 122, in 123, in 124. You can hide the signal card to keep your layout clean. Go back to the Program tab and start the simulation. Now, instead of typing values in the monitoring window, you can simply click on the Boolean signals in your block to control the robot inputs. This makes it much easier and faster to test your logic. Let's start the simulation again. All inputs are currently set to 0, so the ColorNumb signal holds the value 0. When we set input 119 to true, the robot moves to pick the green box, as defined in the default case. Now let's change the ColorNumb value to 10 by setting the appropriate inputs. When we toggle input 119 again, the robot picks the blue box and activates output 103. Next, we set ColorNumb to 20. After toggling input 119, the robot picks the yellow box and activates output 104. Finally, we set ColorNumb to 30. Once input 119 is triggered again, the robot picks the red box and activates output 105. This procedure will also work with the Virtual Robot Controller VRC if you route the signals through a I/O module. In this video, you learned how to simulate I/O mapping and internal signal control using the Robot Controller Simulation Module in iiQWorks.Sim.
We appreciate you watching. Don't forget to hit the subscribe button on the KUKA channel for updates and new videos. For hands-on trainings and courses, head over to the KUKA College. Keep exploring and learning with us.
Making automation easier.